workshop group on Facebook. In case you people want to join in and watch later, you can go on Facebook group.
Okay. I'll just have one request. मुझे बता दीजिए, frame सब कुछ सही से दिख रहा है, कोई issue तो नहीं? मेरा canvas visible है properly?
आप बात कर सकते हैं, can unmute yourself and just answer or question.
Yeah. Okay, can everyone listen to me?
Yes, you're audible, loud and clear.
Okay.
Yes, yes, yes.
Yes, yes. Great.
अब बता दीजिए कब स्टार्ट करना है, हम शुरू करें.
चलिए हम स्टार्ट करते हैं. एंड बिफोर यू स्टार्ट, जस्ट अ स्मॉल इंट्रोडक्शन. वी हैव टुडे सिद्धार्थ थरानी, हु इज अ इंजीनियर, हु इज अ आर्टिस्ट, हु इज अ डिजाइनर, एंड ऑल हिज वर्क्स आर इंस्पायर्ड बाय नेचर. इफ यू सी एनी पीस ऑफ हिज आर्टवर्क, यू विल सी ऑल द लव एंड पैशन ही हैज टुवर्ड्स नेचर. Now he doesn't only work with canvas, he works with anything that you give him. He will create something interesting and create something wonderful. And today we have the most multi-talented artist, Siddhartha Thane, here in our ArtMate session, where he's going to give us a demo of landscape painting on acrylic. So from ArtMate, I welcome you, sir, and this whole thing is for you now. You can start. And guys, you can ask any question, anytime, any query. Please go ahead and let's have an interactive session. Okay? Thank you so much. And let's start.
Okay. Hello, everyone. Sorry for being such a messy stuff, because artist ka jo studio hota hai, आप बहुत क्लीन एक्सपेक्ट नहीं कर सकते. इन द सेम वे हियर आई गॉट माय स्टूडियो, माय स्टफ. यहाँ पे मैं पेंट करता हूँ. मेरे पास आई गॉट अ सेट ऑफ ब्रशेस. लाइक हमें आज जो चीजें लगनी वाली है, उससे पहले चलो ये सब स्टार्ट करने से पहले लेट गेट इंट्रोड्यूस्ड. मैं नाम बता दिया मैम ने, आई एम सिद्धार्थ. आई गेस सभी लोग हिंदी से कंफर्टेबल होंगे. हम ये पूरा कम्युनिकेशन जो है हिंदी लैंग्वेज में रखेंगे. और मुझे मालूम नहीं आपको मेरा चेहरा दिख रहा है कि नहीं, बट अगर आपको कैनवास पूरा दिख रहा है, मुझे उतना ही चाहिए. सो इज माय कैनवास कंप्लीटली विजिबल? ये सब कुछ क्लियर दिख रहा है आपको?
यस.
आप सबसे पहले पेंटिंग क्या होती है इस चीज से शुरू करते हैं. व्हाट इज ए पेंटिंग अकॉर्डिंग टू यू? आपके हिसाब से क्या पेंट करना चाहिए? एनी आंसर्स? आपको क्या लगता है? एनीबडी, आप क्या पेंट करना पसंद करते हो या क्या पेंट करना चाहिए ऐसा आपको लगता है?
एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ योर थॉट्स.
गुड, एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ आवर थॉट. बढ़िया.
हर सुंदर चीज हमें उतारने में मजा आता है.
बिल्कुल सही, ये भी बहुत बढ़िया आंसर है. The base of my painting is a concept. एक जो होता है ना, जिसे कहते हैं thought. मैं हमेशा अपने concept के जरिए एक thought देना चाहता हूँ. आपके answers बिल्कुल सही है. और ये हमेशा हमारा perspective होता है. I like to give thought. ये मेरी painting है, इसको देख के जो मेरे thoughts है वो आपको convey आने चाहिए. And then उसके बाद आपके उस पर जो thoughts होंगे, which are most welcome. ऐसा एक मेरा माइंडसेट होता है. अब आज की जो पेंटिंग है, हम लोग लैंडस्केप करने वाले हैं. लैंडस्केप इज लाइक नेचर. अब आज ये पेंटिंग करने के पीछे मैं आपको एक रीजन दूंगा. आज हम लोग पहली चीज करने वाले हैं, वो है लैंडस्केप पेंटिंग और नेचर पेंटिंग. अब नेचर ही क्यों या लैंडस्केप ही क्यों? क्योंकि वही चीज हम लोग मिस कर रहे हैं. वी आर इन अ 21st century. हम सिटीज में रहते हैं, आसमान छूती बिल्डिंग्स हमारे सामने होती है, बट एक पेड़ जल्दी मिलता नहीं. उस एक पेड़ की, उस एक छाव के लिए हम तरसते हैं. हम दूर दराज जाते हैं नेचर को ढूंढने के लिए. एक खूबसूरत वादियां दिखी नहीं कि वहां पे भी हमको इंसान की घुसपैठ दिखती है. बट जो सुकून होता है, चारों तरफ कोई दखलंदाजी नहीं और सिर्फ नेचर की गोद में हम बैठते हैं, वो सुकून हम लोग मिस कर रहे हैं. एक दफा हम लोगों ने बचपन में देखा होगा, बट आज की जनरेशन को नेचर में खेलना ये चीज ऑलमोस्ट ना के बराबर है. और ग्लोबल वार्मिंग या इन सब के चलते हम लोग वो भी चीजें खोते जा रहे हैं. तो जो चीज जिसको बचाने के लिए हमारे पास आखिरी मौका है, हम उसे अपने कैनवास के जरिए कन्वे करेंगे कि दिस इज नाउ और नेवर. आज हमने ये मिस किया तो हमें ये नेचर कभी नहीं मिलेगा. दैट इज व्हाई वी आर गोइंग टू पेंट नेचर इटसेल्फ. सेकंड थिंग, अब ये पेंटिंग बनने के बाद हमारे घर में कहीं लगने वाली है तो हम क्या पेंट करेंगे. लेट्स गिव वन मोर थॉट. हम आज पेंट करेंगे बहता हुआ पानी, वाटरफॉल, जिसे मोस्ट डिफिकल्ट माना जाता है पेंट करने के लिए, उस फ्लो को लाना. एंड सेकंड चीज, आई डोंट नो वेदर यू आर अ बिलीवर और नॉट, बट वास्तुशास्त्र के अनुसार अगर आपके घर में बहता हुआ पानी होता है, खासकर अगर आप उसे उत्तर दीवार पे लगाते हो, उत्तर दिशा की दीवार पे, तो कहते हैं कि आपके घर में बरकत आती है. तो आपका घर हो या ऑफिस हो, यू ग्रो हेल्थ वाइज, वेल्थ वाइज, यू ग्रो. बहता हुआ पानी स्टैग्नेंसी को अवॉइड करता है एंड योर लाइफ, योर करियर, योर हेल्थ गोज ऑन फ्लो. इसलिए आज हम लोग एक वाटरफॉल पेंट करने वाले. देखिए, मैंने आपको दो कंसेप्ट दिए, दो थॉट्स दिए कि क्यों हम लोग ये चीज करने वाले हैं. और अगर आप लोग भी जेन्युइन कुछ बिलीव करते होंगे तो नेचर को तो अपना नहीं करोगे और बहता हुआ पानी आप अपने घर में लगाओगे. और कुछ फायदा हुआ तो अच्छी बात है, ना भी हुआ तो साइकोलॉजी के जरिए ये देख के आपको खुशी मिलेगी, आपको उस पेंटिंग को देख के अच्छी फीलिंग्स आएंगी, तो हेल्थ वाइज तो आपको बेनिफिट है ही है. सी, दैट्स व्हाट. अब बिलीव करना ना करना आपकी मर्जी. तो चलिए शुरू करते हैं. एक मेरे पास स्ट्रेच कैनवास है. मैं कोई हेवी पैलेट यूज नहीं करता. ये डब्बे का ढक्कन होता है मेरा, उसके ऊपर ये एक मैगजीन का मेरा कलर पैलेट होता है. जब ये भर जाए, I simply throw it away and नया पेज मैगजीन का मैं अपने हाथ में लेता हूँ. एक मैगजीन मुझे आराम से 2-3 साल जाती है. सो नो वरीज. सो मेरा बहुत सिंपल सा कलर पैलेट होता है. आई गॉट अ फ्यू एक्रेलिक कलर्स हियर. मेरे पास कुछ राउंड ब्रश है और कुछ फ्लैट ब्रश है. बस इतनी सी चीज है. एक जार में मेरे पास या मग में पानी है, क्लीन वाटर. एंड एक दो मेरे पास कपड़े है, विचार लाइक क्लीन करने के लिए. एज सिंपल एज दैट. अगर आप सभी लोग मेरे साथ पेंट करने वाले होंगे तो मुझे बता दीजिए, और आप सिर्फ देखने वाले होंगे तो भी बता दीजिए. तो आप एक थम्स अप रेस कर सकते हैं.
सर, मैं साथ में बना रही हूँ.
ओके, आप साथ में बना रहे
हो. मैं बिगनर हूँ, थोड़ा बहुत किया हुआ है.
बढ़िया. सो कितने लोग है जो साथ में बनाने वाले है? आई गॉट वन.
मैं बना सकता हूँ, आपको लगता है? थोड़ा बहुत किया हुआ है.
हम सभी लोग बनाएंगे अभी. अगर आप मटेरियल है तो हम सभी लोग बनाएंगे.
नहीं, मैं बना पाऊंगी.
आप डेफिनेटली बनाओगे. आई गारंटी दैट.
कैन आई यूज 300 GSM पेपर फॉर दिस? देन आई विल श्योरली मेक अलोंग.
यस, आप भी बना सकते हो, पेपर के ऊपर भी बना.
थैंक यू.
आपके पास अगर एक्रेलिक्स नहीं होंगे और जो पोस्टर कलर्स आते हैं वो देखिए कांच की बॉटल्स वगैरह में आते हैं, या इवन यू हैव वाटर कलर्स, स्टिल आई डोंट माइंड. कलर्स आते हैं, एक ट्रांसपेरेंट कलर्स, एक ओपन कलर्स. लाइक इफ यू डोंट हैव एक्रेलिक्स एंड पोस्टर कलर्स, एप्लीकेशन सेम. देते चाहिए. मैम, कल वी बिगिन.
हाँ जी सबजन यस बोल रहे हैं.
ओके गुड. तो अब जब भी हम पेंटिंग करते हैं लैंडस्केप, हम सबसे पीछे वाली चीज से शुरू करके आगे आते हैं. एक्रेलिक ओवरलैप हो सकते हैं, सो हम सबसे डिस्टिंक्ट ऑब्जेक्ट जो है उसको पहले पेंट करेंगे और सबसे क्लोज जो ऑब्जेक्ट है उसको सबसे लास्ट में पेंट करेंगे. और सबसे दूर जितना मुझे पता है आता है आसमान. सो व्हाट आई एम गोना डू, आई एम गोना पेंट द स्काई. अब स्काई किसी भी कलर का हो सकता है. मैं थोड़ा सा ब्लू से स्टार्ट करना चाहूंगा. I'll go for a little bit of Prussian blue. Yes, I got here. It's a Prussian blue या navy blue आप इसे कहते हो. मैंने अपने कलर पैलेट में थोड़ा सा navy blue निकाल लिया. Then I'm gonna go for थोड़ा सा sky blue, light blue. अगर आपके पास ये कलर नहीं है तो आप white भी यूज कर सकते हो. दोनों एप्लीकेशन सेम होते हैं. मैंने थोड़ा सा sky blue निकाल लिया. और इसमें हाँ मैं आपके लिए व्हाइट भी निकाल देता हूँ. अगर आपके पास वो फिक्स शेड नहीं है सो आप एक ब्लू, कोई भी ब्लू एंड कोई भी व्हाइट. सो मैंने थोड़ा सा व्हाइट निकाल लिया. अब स्काई सिंगल कलर का नहीं होता और होना भी नहीं चाहिए. उसमें जब तक कुछ लेना हो सो व्हाट आई एम गोना डू, मैं इसके साथ थोड़ा सा येलो एड करने वाला हूँ. जो होता है सनराइज तो आसमान नीचे येलो होता है और उसके बाद जैसे ही आप स्काई में ऊपर जाते हो वो ब्लू होते जाता है. सो हियर आई एम गोना टेक सम येलो. थोड़ा सा येलो निकाल लिया. और लेके ले लो, ये थोड़ा सा कम लग रहा है मुझे. ओके तो इस वक्त टेक्निकली मेरे पैलेट पे बेसिकली पांच शेड से छह एक्चुअली आप देख सकते हो. आई गॉट डार्क ब्लू, लाइट ब्लू एंड व्हाइट. ये मैं ब्लूज की शेड्स ली है. देन येलो, डार्क येलो या येलो ऑकर. देन लाइट येलो, थोड़ा सा पीच कलर है. पीच नहीं होगा तो भी चलेगा. व्हाइट और पीच ऑप्शनल है, डजंट मैटर. आप तीन कलर से भी काम कर सकते हो, ब्लू, व्हाइट एंड येलो. देन आई एम गोना टेक अ फ्लैट ब्रश. मैं बाकी ब्रशेस को निकाल देता हूँ अपने पैलेट से. जगह हो जाए यहाँ पे. अरे मैंने अभी आपको फ्लैट ब्रश दिखाया था.
आप चेक कर सकते हैं. मैं उसका लिंक भी यहाँ पे शेयर कर दूंगी. ओके थैंक यू मैम. एक्चुअली वी आर बिगिनर्स तो हम एकदम कैच कर नहीं पाएंगे सब.
ओके डोंट वरी, आप मेरे साथ पेंट कीजिए. तो स्टेप वन मैंने फ्लैट ब्रश लिया. ये 1 इंच का फ्लैट ब्रश है. अब मैं डायरेक्टली मैं एक्रेलिक्स में कहीं भी पानी मिक्स नहीं कर रहा हूँ. मैंने बस कलर में इसको डिप कर लिया ताकि थोड़ा सा ब्रश जो है वो मॉइस्ट रहे. सी मैंने एक्स्ट्रा पानी भी निकाल दिया. गो फॉर पेंटिंग विद सम ब्लूज. अब देखो मैंने ऊपर की तरफ डार्क ब्लू अप्लाई करना शुरू किया. कलर्स को अप्लाई करते वक्त हम लोग कंजूसी नहीं करते. जितना हमें कलर्स अच्छे से मिलते हैं हम अप्लाई करते हैं. Being a stretched canvas, मैं इसी कलर को इसके ऊपर के सिरे पे भी अप्लाई कर दूंगा ताकि वो ऑल तरफ से कलर हो जाए. बाद में परफेक्शन देख लेंगे कितना हुआ है कितना नहीं. बट अगर स्ट्रेच कैनवस होता है तो वी गो फॉर ऑल द साइड्स. ओके यहाँ पे मैंने ये lots of ब्लू अप्लाई कर दिया. अब एक्रेलिक कलर्स वैसे जल्दी ड्राई होते हैं तो हमें उसको उसके स्पीड से चलना पड़ता है. तो अब मैंने थोड़ा सा लाइट ब्लू लिया एंड मैंने नीचे एक लेयर दे दिया. मैंने ब्रश को बिल्कुल क्लीन नहीं किया है. मैंने उसी ब्रश से वही कलर उठाया हुआ है. आपके सामने मैंने लाइट ब्लू पिक किया एंड मैंने डायरेक्टली इसके ऊपर एक गाढ़ा शेड अप्लाई कर दिया. अब जब मेरा नीचे का लेयर फ्लैट हो गया, देखो मैं उससे हॉरिजॉन्टल मूवमेंट कर रहा हूँ. अब मैं इसकी मार्जिन को मिक्स कर रहा हूँ. बिकॉज दोनों कलर जो है वो वेट है तो मार्जिन पे वो काफी इजीली मर्ज हो रहे हैं. एंड मैं स्ट्रोक्स की डायरेक्शन भी सिर्फ हॉरिजॉन्टल रख रहा हूँ ताकि मुझे एक यूनिफॉर्म मर्जिंग मिले, मुझे स्काई का एक यूनिफॉर्म ग्रेडियंट मिले. इसके बीच में अगर थोड़े से पट्टे आपके छूट जाते हैं सो नॉट टू वरी, बिकॉज आसमान एकदम ही क्लीन नहीं होता. बादलों के बेल्ट उसमें होते ही होते हैं. देखिए यहाँ पे हमने बस दो कलर्स को आहिस्ता से मिक्स कर लिया, जो एक्स्ट्रा था मैंने उसको वाइप करने के लिए मैंने कॉर्नर्स पे वाइप कर लिया ताकि मेरा जो बॉक्स है वो रिटेन हो गया। अब मैं इस ब्रश को क्लीन करने वाला हूँ बिकॉज उस पर डार्क ब्लू कलर अप्लाई हो चुका है। मैंने इसको क्लीन किया ये आपके सामने, मैंने इस कॉटन फैब्रिक से इसको अच्छे से क्लीन कर लिया, मैंने इसमें से सारा ब्लू कलर निकाल लिया। नाउ मैं फिर से लाइट ब्लू लेने वाला हूँ, मैं इसके और एक लेयर देने वाला हूँ ताकि मुझे दो लेयर्स मिले। अब मुझे ब्लू को लाइट करना है, अब मैं ऊपर नहीं जाऊंगा डार्क ब्लू के पास, मुझे वहां पर छेड़खानी नहीं करनी है। अब मैं सीधा व्हाइट कलर लूंगा ताकि मैं स्काई को और लाइट कर सकूं। अब देखो मैंने बिना उसको क्लीन किए ही मैंने उसमें व्हाइट ऐड करना शुरू किया। यहाँ पे आप देखो अब मुझे तीन शेड्स मिली है, डार्क ब्लू, मीडियम ब्लू और लाइट ब्लू। और ये देखो मैं बहुत उसको इन डेप्थ मर्ज नहीं कर रहा हूँ, ये जो बीच में डार्क लाइट के पैचेस आ रहे हैं मैं इसको ऐसे ही छोड़ रहा हूँ बिकॉज हमको एक बड़ा सा होराइजन दिखाना है। और जो बड़ा सा होराइजन होता है ये आप देखो इसमें ऐसे स्काई के बेल्स आते ही रहते हैं, तो इसलिए हमें बहुत ही प्रिसाइज नहीं होना है। जनरली हम लोग परफेक्शन के चक्कर में बहुत प्रिसाइज करते हैं एंड तब वो चीज़ आर्टिफिशियल हो जाती है। आप देखो आपकी घर की दीवारों से लेके आपकी स्किन टोन तक कहीं ना कहीं थोड़े से स्पॉट्स, थोड़ी डस्ट, कुछ ना कुछ होता है। नेचर में एकदम क्लीन कहीं कुछ नहीं मिलेगा, यू विल नॉट फाइंड एनीथिंग टू मच क्लीन। वहाँ पे कहीं ना कहीं कुछ ना कुछ इम्परफेक्शन होता ही है, रॉनेस होती है, तो हम भी बहुत क्लीन नहीं करेंगे, वी विल फॉलो दैट रॉनेस। ओके यहाँ पे हमने एक व्हाइट का लेयर दे दिया, ये काफी अच्छे से बैठ गया है एंड सी वो कलर ड्राई भी होने लग गए थे। ओके देन अब मैं थोड़ा सा इसमें पीच इंट्रोड्यूस करूंगा। पीच इंट्रोड्यूस इसलिए करना है बिकॉज आई वॉन्ट अ ट्रांजिशन, मुझे डायरेक्टली व्हाइट से येलो में जंप नहीं करना है। आप पीच कलर को
सर, सर
यस
ब्लर आ रहा है ना, सिर्फ मुझे ब्लर दिख रहा है कि औरों को भी?
यस थोड़ा सा ब्लर हो रहा है,
काफी ब्लर है सर, कलर समझ नहीं आ रहा अभी लास्ट में।
ओके अब ये देखिए इज इट गुड नाउ?
यस
बेटर सर।
सर एक बार लास्ट कलर फिर से बताइए ना।
ओके मैंने पीच कलर यूज किया। आप पीच कलर को बनाने के लिए अगर आपके पास डायरेक्ट पीच कलर अवेलेबल नहीं है, आप रेड उसमें काफी सारा व्हाइट बनाओगे और थोड़ा सा येलो डालोगे तो आपका पीच कलर बन जाएगा। मुझे ये पीच कलर इसलिए चाहिए था क्योंकि मुझे अभी येलो में ट्रांजिट करना है। ब्लू आर कूल कलर्स, येलोज आर वार्म कलर्स, और मैं डायरेक्टली जंप करूंगा तो वो काफी ऑड लगेगा ट्रांजिशन, इसलिए मैंने बिफोर अप्लाइंग येलो थोड़ा सा पीच अप्लाई किया ताकि वो एक मुझे ट्रांजिशन बेल्ट मिल गया वहां पे। एंड नाउ आई एम अप्लाइंग द लाइट येलो ताकि ये पीच कलर के साथ बहुत इजीली अब्सॉर्ब होता है और मुझे एक बहुत ही स्मूथ सा ग्रेडियंट दे रहा है, आप देख सकते हो।
सर प्लीज बी इन इंग्लिश, इट वुड बी बेटर।
ओके यू वांट मी टू गो इन इंग्लिश? श्योर
यस।
नाउ आई हैव अप्लाइड येलो कलर एंड एज यू कैन सी because of the intermediate peach color the yellow is going a good transition, you can see it is smoothly transiting itself into the blues and without any margin or absorption it's giving me a gentle sky gradient.
And now, before that, for giving peach what did you do sir?
Okay I'll explain the entire thing, let me just apply this yellow first so that it won't dry out as acrylics are quite quick drying colors. Yes?
The peach has to be completely hidden?
Yes, it is just a transition medium. The peach is not there to look more prominent. I just needed to transfer my yellow gradient into that white. So as a vehicle for transition, I use the peach color. It simply absorbed my yellow pigments and transited it into white quite smoothly. That was the huge. It was never meant to be shown very clearly. Okay. This much.
Right?
So I'm not going to go anything lower than this. This will be my sky gradient. This is the horizon line. So this is what our sky should look like. I just wrap the extra colors on the sides. That's my habit. But when the brush gets clean, and as I use box canvas, it gives me a good corners. Okay. So that the way we had a smooth blue to yellow soft transition. As you can see here, I'll just move it more center. It is, you can see, it is a smooth transition. You're not getting much more abrupt bells, and we are ready to go for the next phase.
So yellow ochre has not been used here. It's just a yellow, golden yellow.
Yes, it is golden yellow. You can use even yellow ochre, whichever gradient you like. I just used two shades of each color, a lighter one, a darker one. We got a light blue, a dark blue, a light yellow, a dark yellow. Using multiple shades give it more naturalness instead of giving one single shade.
So in the last, this thing, yellow ochre has been used, right, to darken it?
It is not exactly yellow ochre. If I say the exact shade, it's a permanent yellow medium.
Okay, okay.
But you can even use yellow ochre. It will be just a little bit darker than this, but not much. Now this way, we got our skies done here. Generally, we wait for 15-20 minutes for it to settle. But unfortunately, we don't have that much of time. We don't have 3-4 hours to paint a painting. So we're going to proceed with our next step. We're going to create some mountains. Now for that, as you have seen, there is an effect in nature. You see distinct object in different colors. If the mountain is gray or made of black stone, but you are looking at it from a far distance, you will see it into use of blues or magentas or pinks or purples. That's called as atmospheric effect. And that's why we see colors differently from a distance, apart from which they originally are. So right now, to start with my long distant mountains, I'll try to go for a bit magenta. So here I got magenta, deep magenta. Here it is. I'm gonna take out some deep magenta in my color palette. And then I'm gonna, as my skies are with yellows, I'm gonna dilute the magenta in yellows. I'll show you how. First, I took a bit magenta here. मैंने उसमें थोड़ा सा white add किया हुआ है. I'm just lightening it.
So can you show your palette? How you mix?
See, I got a magenta. It is quite colorful. Yeah, it is magenta. मैंने इसमें थोड़ा सा white add कर दिया. ताकि वो बहुत डार्क ना रहे, because I got a deep shade of magenta, I want a purple hue, बहुत डार्क नहीं चाहिए, इसलिए मैंने उसमें व्हाइट ऐड किया, see, now I can get a lighter version. Okay, now I'm going to draw some random mountains. Now the skyline will be very randomized. I'm not very peculiar about what my strokes are going. I'm just gonna go with a few layers. Now I'm not worried whether it is absorbing a yellow or not, as you can see, it will give me a more natural look. Just going for random strokes. I'm not concerned about the edges.
Sir, इसको कलर को कैसे बनाएं, एक बार वापस रिपीट कीजिएगा ना.
Okay, मैंने क्या किया? I took deep magenta, which is a kind of a purple color. Now the shade which is available with me is much darker. It's like a dark purple, deep magenta. So what I did, I simply dropped some white in it just to lighten it up. Otherwise it would have been too dark. If you have a purple or let's say a light magenta color with you, you can go for that. I just wanted the mountains to be a little lighter shade of magenta or purples, not much darker. And the skyline is very random. I'm not focusing on anything much more peculiar. You can see. And now I'm just going to dilute it. That's how my skies goes.
this is just one layer of mountain. I'm gonna put at least two layers to get that distant effect. You can see, I'm just going with a random shapes. Mountains are random. You don't need to worry about the shape. Just make sure it's not too plain to watch. So I'm just playing with some curves and I just got my mountain here ready. This is my first layer. Yahan pe, there will be a different mountain. So I'm not going to that extent. This is any random concept. I'm not with a guy with a plan. So koi plan fix nahi hai. We are just going with the flow. So what I'm doing, ab mujhe, what I'm gonna do, hamara jo atmosphere hai, it is yellow. You can see here. Ab mujhe is mountain pe kuch cloud supply karna hai. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna take some yellow, light yellow, and I'm gonna just wash it here. I'm giving a transition to the mountain. As you can see, my mountains are going from little bit magenta to brown, because brown mixing with yellow goes in magenta. Hamare paas waqt nahi hai. We can't wait for it to dry, because this is mountain will take 15-20 minutes. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna simply merge it into yellows. Okay, I don't care, because I'm gonna have different colors. I'm just gonna go with the vertical strokes. Now, why I'm going this vertical strokes? It will look like clouds are floating over the mountains. And as the mountain's horizon is yellow, the clouds will also appear a bit yellowish. That way, I did my first layer. I simply transited the mountains back into yellows. Next thing, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna again draw second layer of mountain. So I got the same magenta here. The color was already ready. I'll simply go for another layer. Again, the mountains are completely random. There is no plan of action. Whatever I feel, I'm just putting on the strokes. Okay, let's give a bit of rise here. Okay, that is what my second layer should look like. Now you can see there's a distant effect. The previous mountains are looking a bit far and the next one are looking a bit closer. That is what we call as atmospheric effect. Two layers are sufficient for us. Again, I'm gonna use some yellow and merge its base into yellow. So we could move for our third layer. You can wait if you are going to draw it later for the mountains to dry a little bit, as it will be easier for you to merge them when they are dried a bit. Okay, that's how our second layer is going. Done. We will stop at two layers only for the distant mountain. Next thing we'll need is our final layer. Okay, so any doubt up till now? Any doubt till here? I'll just simply turn it a bit more like this, so you'll be getting a clear view. Okay, any doubt till now? Any questions here? Shall I proceed?
Sir, I have doubt.
Yes, please ask.
Peach color.
Why I use the peach color? See, to make the peach color. To make a peach color, you need a bit red. You put some white in that red. That will give you a pink color. But the peach color has a tint of yellow also. So what you do, you drop a little yellow in that pink. That gives you a peach color.
Sir, what to do if we don't have red color?
What to do if you don't have red color? Do you have anything like crimson?
almost finished.
Okay, now you need something. You should have orange.
Sir, I can make orange then.
So take some orange and add a bit of white to it. Even it will give you a closer shade of peach.
Okay, sir.
Okay. So that is a second layer. Now we'll go to our final mountains. So before that, let's add some mountain here also. Just a bit glimpses for us to give. I got some blue left with me. This is not on purpose. So instead of wasting this blue, I'm just going to add a few more mountains here. I'm just gonna go for a bit higher mountains here. Why I'm not going for yellow or magenta here? Because here the mountains are much more higher and the closest shade here is blue. That's why I'm going for a bit blue mountains here. I could have gone for a magenta if it was down, because in the atmospheric effect, you get the closest atmospheric shades reflected on your objects. And here, blue is more prominent at this height. So I'm going for blues. I'm not going to gradient it because my next mountain is going to overlap it anyway. So it's just a piece of mountain here. Done. Now I'm going to go for my prominent mountain. Now what my prominent mountain should look like. Let's go. I'm going to have again a little bit of magenta, deep magenta. And then I'm going to have lots of brown. See, I got a burnt umber, which is a brown shade here. You can go for a red and black to get a brown. If you don't have a direct brown, you can go for even red and blue to get a deep violet color. But brown is generally available with everyone. So go for any dark color, doesn't matter. If you have a green, mix some blue with that and go for a deep green. Take any color which is close to brown or black. As we are going for a mountain, look like a Sahyadri scape. So I have taken a brown in my palette. I have some magenta in my palette. And now I'm gonna go and paint a front mountain. Let's begin. This is the last and final shade. Over this mountain, our waterfalls will flow. So why I took magenta again? Because mountain should go from a distance. So here I'm going for my first mountain hilltop. Now I'm not going to merge it with any other color. I'm going to go for entire solid color. Wow, it's raining outside. Good ambience, good thing for us to paint. I'm gonna go, let's elevate it. The shapes are purely randomized. There is no plan. I'm just going the way I feel I should go. There is no particular plan about that. Okay, here we go. So these will be distant mountain. So I'm going to paint them in magenta. Now as we are approaching closer, I'm adding shades of brown. I'm going to raise the height. Here I said, you got a raise in the height. These are like Sahyadris. You know our Sahyadri mountains. They are like.
Sir, ye color kaise le?
This is brown. This is plain brown.
First one, sir. First mountain, jo hai.
Brown color, burnt umber, brown.
वो अलग लग रहा है ना color.
ऐसा लग रहा है आपको, but it's plain simple brown. हाँ, मेरे palette में थोड़ा सा magenta color था, तो वो उसमें use दे रहा होगा.
Okay.
So clean नहीं किया. Before leaving magenta color, the purple one, मैंने brush को wash नहीं किया है, because जरूरत नहीं थी. I want them to look similar. Then यहाँ से हम लोग एक mountain top draw कर लेते हैं. This is our maximum height.
Just lighten it up. Otherwise, it would have been.
मेरा फ्रंट माउंटेन रहेगा. फ्रंट
फाउंटेन रहेगा.
एक्सक्यूज मी सर.
यस.
एक्चुअली जो मेरा ब्राउन है वो थोड़ा है ना येलो शेड दे रहा है. एक्चुअली मैं एक्रेलिक कलर से कर रही हूं.
यू कैन ऐड ब्लू टू दैट ब्राउन. आप उसमें यू कैन ऐड सम ब्लू एंड सम रेड सो दैट won't give you yellow shade. You can add a blue to that brown. Aap usme you can add some blue and some red. So that won't give you yellow shade. Okay, now we are done with this part. Ab mujhe pura isko color karna hai. So I'm just going to fill up the area. It's nothing. I'm just going to fill the entire landscape. So that it gets dry soon. And hum log next layer ke liye move kar sakte. थोड़े कलर्स मेरे वेट होने की वजह से आपको पीछे के येलो के ग्लिम्सेस दिखेंगे. डजंट मैटर, हम उसको कवर अप कर लेंगे. अगर आपके बैकग्राउंड पूरा ड्राई हो चुका है तो आपके इसमें नहीं दिखेंगे. अब मेरे यहाँ पे बाहर बारिश भी चल रही है सो मेरे कलर्स इतने जल्दी ड्राई नहीं होने वाले. बट आई डोंट माइंड, वो होते हैं ना होते हैं, डजंट मैटर. सी दैट्स द ब्यूटी, लेट द कलर्स प्ले डर्टी, डजंट मैटर. वो कलर्स को आपस में मिक्स मत होने दो. लेट देम डिस्टर्ब द रिदम. वो ब्यूटीफुल ही लगेगा. सो सी आई एम जस्ट गोइंग ऑल द वे ब्राउन विथ इट. जस्ट एलिवेट इट, यहाँ पे रखता हूँ आपको बॉटम तक दिखे. सी आई एम जस्ट गोइंग विथ द ऑल द वे ब्राउन्स. ओके, लेट मी गेट इट डन क्विकली. मैं थोड़ा इस तरफ मजेंडा ही ऐड कर रहा हूँ बिकॉज वो टिंट वहाँ पे मुझे चाहिए था. नाउ आई एम जस्ट गोइंग टू क्लीन द पैलेट. पर मैंने इसमें ब्लू ऐड किया नीचे की तरफ से. आई एम जस्ट गोइंग फॉर रैंडम शेड्स. इसमें कोई लॉजिक नहीं है. व्हाई एम गोइंग अ बिट लाइटर शेड्स एट द बॉटम, बिकॉज नीचे आते आते द माउंटेन्स गेट मोर लेस स्टीपर, सो यू गेट अ बिट लाइटर वर्जन ऑफ द स्टोन. दैट्स व्हाई आई एम गोइंग फॉर अ बिट lighter colors at the bottom, nothing else. But ultimately the goal is to make it completely single color so that we can overlap it. Don't think there is no specific logic doing here. I'm just cleaning my palette. I'm just using the colors so that it won't get wasted. Of course it's a stone, so stone can be of multiple shade. I'm using the same logic and I'm just cleaning my palette. When I'm going to some, जो भी मुझे colors मिल रहा है, whatever colors is left in my palette, I am merging them with the base. Okay, we'll ये कुछ मिनट में settle हो जाएगा and we'll move for the final waterfall. But of course, इसको हमको 10-15 मिनट देने पड़ेंगे settle होने में. Till then हम लोग कुछ clouds बना लेंगे. Today's big problem is the climate. It's very chilling. I'm sitting at Trambakeshwar. It is very cold here, plus it's raining outside. You can hear the sound of the rain, so it will take much longer for my colors to dry up because moisture is locked in the atmosphere. Okay, there I done. I have cleaned my almost off my palette. I have used all the peculiar shades so that there should be a variation to my colors. I'm just adding light colors randomly at the bottom. You can see it's just giving me a mixture of tints and tones. And extra brown I'm adding on the sideways. So that ye bacha hua to kya karna hai best kar. Done. This way we completed the basic structure. Now we are going to move for the details. Yeah, I'm just making sure ki kahi color ka zyada layer na reh jaye. So that वो जल्दी dry हो जाए. I'm just spreading the color so that it gets dried quickly. Okay, we are done here. This is what a basic structure should look like. Let give me a minute. I'm gonna close my window as the water is coming inside. I mean, due to air, the raindrops coming inside. Okay. Sorry for the trouble. Now,
Our skyscape is ready.
Excuse me. I have a question. What is the size of the canvas you've taken?
It's a 14 by 18, standard A3 size.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Okay. Now, see, our sky is not completely dry, but to some extent, it is a bit moist. I need actually complete dry sky for dry brushing. There's a technique called dry brushing, wherein we can smudge the colors into clouds. But unfortunately, the sky will not get dry that quickly. So I'm going to go for a wet on. What I'm going to do, I need some clouds in the atmosphere. It should not go like a plain straight way. So I'm going to add some clouds. Now clouds are of multiple colors. I'm going to start with some white. I'm taking some white. It's a titanium white, as you can see here. I'm going to drop some titanium white on my palette. Little bit, not much more. I'm going to take a brush. I need a rough brush, an old worn out brush. Just give me a minute. I'm going to take a bit worn out brush here. Yeah, your old brush are even useful because these brush are good for doing such a lot of things. Okay, as you can see, I got a worn out brush. Its hairs are not much clean, but that's what I need. It's an old brush, it's worn out completely. And I need the exact thing. So I'm not gonna wet it. I'm gonna just use as it is, a dry brush in dry color. I just pick some color on my brush. The brush is not moist. It has not been dipped in water. Then here, I need some clouds. I'm just gonna drop it. Now I'm not gonna go for the color again. See, the color is getting settled on the palette. And as I'm coming down, I'm losing the color. So I'm just getting some rough strokes. And as you can see, I'm getting a good cloud texture. Can you see it clearly or should I zoom it a bit? It's possible to zoom in here. Oh, no. Anyway, I just pull the canvas then. I'll simply place it down here so that it won't reflect much light. Now it's much clearer. So what I picked some color. I started drawing random shapes of cloud. I'm just dabbing it. As my brush is losing color, it's giving me a diluvian effect at the base of the cloud. And you can see I'm getting a perfect texture. No hard work, a smart work. Are we good here? Let's drop in more clouds. Same technique. I took some color and while coming down, I'm just cleaning my brush on the canvas itself. And it's giving me random cloud textures. I'm overlapping some clouds so that it should look natural. As you can see, now it's going good. See, that's how we draw good clouds. Okay, that's enough for here. We don't want to make it too cloudy. I'll just drop one in here somewhere in the middle so that it should look like a good transition. I'm simply dropping the color and then I'm simply cleaning its base so that it gives me some random texture. And we are done. So we got a few, what we can say, clouds here. And these clouds are like white. Now I'm going again on the yellow side. So here while going on the yellow side, I took medium yellow color. It is medium yellow. You can even take orange and add some light yellow to it. Technique will be same, no change. We're just changing the colors of the cloud. So now I'm going for again a dry brush. This time I took yellow. And I simply drop some light clouds here. Now these clouds will be in minute details.
might not be that much visible from camera point of view. I'm just going some dark cloud here. Then I'm just going some more clouds up here. Here the clouds will be more prominently visible as contrast will be high. You're just dropping few random clouds here and there. Why we are going for yellow? As the background here is yellowish. So the clouds are nothing but water balls, which absorbs the nearby color. That's why we are going for the surrounding colors and we are going for random clouds. We drop some more clouds at the bottom. I'm just going to add a white to the yellow. Get a lighter shade. I'm going to add some light yellow clouds. The same technique here. I'm just gonna wipe extra color from my brush. And as you can see, some light yellow clouds are coming our way. Not much, one or two, that will suffice. One from this side. And clouds can be of any shape, so you don't need to worry much at how your brush is going. Done. Now we got a few clouds in the atmosphere and it's going in a natural way. The sky is looking much more beautiful. Okay. Now it is still drying. So in the meantime, we will texture the mountain. Now how to texture the mountain? The mountains are not always entirely black. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna take some greens here. So not exactly greens, of course I'm gonna go for yellow ochre. This is a yellow ochre. I'm dropping some yellow ochre on my palette. Then I'm gonna drop some green on my palette. It feels just olive green, regular olive green color. I'm dropping some regular olive green color on my palette. Bas, I'm just need two colors. And okay, for a twist of tone, I'm gonna take some light green also. If you don't have a light green, mix yellow in olive green or dark green. Just took some parrot green. Done. Now what we are going to do, we're going to texturize the mountain. How to texturize the mountain? Mountain is compressed of grass and some other bulks, and that too on the slopes only, not where there is only straight wall. So what we need to do, we need to add some element of ochres here. Now what I'm going to do, just going to take it a bit more closer for you to see the textures clearly. I'm going to add, I took some yellow and green together. I'm just going to make a mountain slope here. I'm not going to, for the rest half side, it should look like a shadow region. You can see on the rest half, it will look like a shadow. And on this side, it will look like mountain is covering with greens and shades of other things. A bit gentle slope here is sufficient. Till then, if the side is drying, we're just going for, oh, excuse me for that sound. We live in a quite close to nature. So we got visitors and not all visitors are that much welcoming. So sometimes they scream like this after seeing a beautiful nature. And I'll show you around when we are done with the session. I'll show you real nature around. Okay, I'm just gonna go a bit here also. See, I'm not very particular about where my stroke is heading. I'm just giving some random falls here. It's very, very random. There's no plan of action. I'm just simply making some rough mountain fractals here so that mountain get a bit depth. So it's like this. like this. Mountain tops are usually green. You get a good soil cover there. As we are coming down, you're not much going for details. You can see I'm not giving any stroke in the bottom areas. I'm just going for some top stuff and done. And I'm just gonna add some pure parrot green in the upper areas. Yes, that's my parrot green. And I'm gonna change my brush. I'm gonna again take the rough brush. I need even rougher brush than this. So I'm gonna search a very old worn out brush if I have some with me. Give me a minute. I need a very, very, very old and very worn out brush. I'm just gonna grab it all. Yes, I got one. It's a round brush only. See, it's my old brush. What I'm gonna do. I'm gonna, without wasting anything, I'm just gonna go. I got some parrot green. I'm just creating textures. Now my colors are not that much dried, so it's gonna get absorbed. If you let them settle, you will get a more clean finish than mine. Because my background colors is a thick layer and they are not much more dry. Okay, I'm gonna just go fill a few mountain tops. It's a replication of a grass. Okay, we'll have some more here and then we are done with that. Just drawing some rough fractals here over the top. I'm leaving them as it is as my strokes are blending down, because when it comes to a straight slopy wall, you won't find any grass there because the soil will not hold anything. They are just stones and barren rocks. So whatever decoration you have to do, do it on the top. And that's just a minute observations. When you roam around nature, you can observe the mountains like this. There are greens on the top. As you come down, they get darker because there is no grass at the bottom. So I'm just going to drop something here. And we got some tops covered. That's it. So these are our mountains. Let's add one more layer here. In this part, it's looking quite empty. So I'm gonna go for, let's take magenta only. It will give us more lighter version. I took some magenta. That's our final section. Why we are adding this mountain? Because we need time for this colors to get settled before we draw the final waterfall. So I just took some magenta. I mixed a bit white in that, lighten it up. Now once these are dried, we are going to draw the waterfall, main technique. Okay, in the meantime, as they are settling, I'm just going to draw for last mountain. So I just took magenta, I mixed a bit white with that. I'm adding some more white to get it a pink shade. Okay, I'm done here. Let's drop a few more textures in the front. Let's drop a bit like, okay, we got a bit edgy stuff here. Then it's going all the way down for the slope. I'm not gonna go much particular about it for the finishing. I'll just let it smoothly transit in the previously given rough thing. There's no need to finish it off. Okay, this much is good. I'm not letting it finished enough. I'm just putting it down here. Okay, that's done. And let's add some more fracture from this side. Okay, that much is sufficient. And I'm not gonna finish it either. It's just gonna go here and end randomly. Done. Now I'm gonna take again that green which I had previously in my palette and I'm going to add some green cover over these mountains. It's still drying up. You can see it's not yet ready for the waterfall to fall. So I just took some bit green, and on the top of this, I'm just dropping some cover. Because mountains are green on the top, we got some grass cover. I'm just going for some random green here. Not very much peculiar. Let's add some yellow ochre to that. It will give more natural look, because nature is not that much green. Visible, no? Okay, you just missed the part. My mistake. I just dropped some mountains here, and I'm just adding that thing. I just took a look at that. So it's like, just going to add a few shades of yellows, indicating that it has some grass cover. Few random patches here and there. Random patches on this side. And now last we are left with is the mesmerizing waterfall. Let's get prepared for that waterfall. Now here, I have a doubt with the waterfall, how good it will fall, because our colors are not completely dried. Let me make sure that our colors are dried so we can get a perfect waterfall. Mom, can we have the hair dryer? Yes. My father has a hair dryer here. Not much more handy this time, but now we are going to dry the colors for 2 minutes so that our waterfall won't get disturbed. I'm using a hair dryer. I won't recommend you to use a hair dryer because it burns the moisture and the color sometimes get faded. But using a hairdryer is not a good idea. You let it dry naturally. We need time. I'm just going to dry it. It's going to take a bit 2-5 minutes for it to dry. Bear with that, please.
It's already looking so beautiful.
Yes.
Well, the main thing is coming, which is going to add more beauty to that. And those will be the beautiful, majestic waterfalls. But for that, I need the canvas to be dried completely. And due to the moisture in the air, we're not getting dinged that easily. Otherwise, in the summers, it would have been completely dry up till now. Acrylics like dries in minutes. But at my place, here in Trambakeshwar, we're having a lot of moisture.
I I think it's raining all over Maharashtra. So
yeah,
everywhere it's an amazing weather.
Okay, it's getting bright. Good. That's enough. This much is enough. We can't go for all the way long. Now the main thing is coming. The waterfalls are coming. I'm gonna take simply white color. It's nothing, just pure titanium white. Well, my white is gone. Yeah, it is here. So what I did, I'm just dropping some plain white. It's regular titanium white. I'm gonna take a long handle brush. Quite precise. I'm taking a good brush. See, it's a good brush. It has a right pointy bristles. I took some color. Now, let's throw the first waterfall from here. It can come anywhere from the mountain. So it will like fall here. Apart from that, it will bounce and will fall here. Now, as it comes down, the flow gets expanded. So as it's coming down, I'm gonna just with some random strokes, I'm opening up the flow. I'm spreading it wide. So that you can see, I'm just expanding the flow. I'm not adding any color. I'm just scattering the existing color so that it should look random. Because there are lots of wind blowing on, so the water gets usually scattered all the way along. While falling from such a great height, the water don't fall straight away. It gets randomized, it falls. You can see it's going with the wind. That's our first fall coming right down. Let's go for a second. I'm just gonna close it for you. So let's go for a few more lines of water. Second, we'll go a bigger flow. We will add it from here at this point. Let's throw it out like this. And then let's throw it out from here at the same height. We'll go. Like this.
And Hari. Hari. Nimde Hari pehla hang gayi tu.
Now I'm expanding it.
So, which brush number you are using?
It's just a round brush, normal round brush, size 4.
Okay.
The key is how you throw the water out, the flow. That's the key. It looks more natural, less color, more of a randomness. And when the water hits ground, it doesn't like go randomly. I mean, we can add a few more falls if you want. I'll show one more. See, yeah, then sufficient. So we'll add some more fall from here. Let's go it from this height. And let's go it down straight. So I'm taking very less amount of color. While I'm doing it, I'm just gonna go in a random fashion, spreading the color. Because winds are blowing, then the water don't fall straight away. It gets thrown here and there from such a great heights. See, that's the key of drawing good waterfall. Don't make it too much stagnant. And then when it falls down somewhere like here, it won't just fall. It will give some fog kind of a thing. So on these mountain tops, what we are going to do, you're going to have some like dust kind of thing. It's water droplets who get rise up because of the fall. As water hits the ground, it gets elevated. And you see some water vapors rising up in the atmosphere where the water falls. So at the base, you don't see much clear water. You see it's going randomly and you can see a fog or a smoke kind of thing at the base of any waterfall. The greater the fall.
Which number brush are you using, sir?
Same brush. It's number 4 round brush. It's same brush. See, I'm just generating some random fog structure where the water is falling so that it will give me the
effect. I'm just going just like the clouds. I'm drawing random strokes and I'm generating random fog so that it gives me that fall effect. I'm just adding a few more element of white so it will look more natural. It will give me a layers, a bit more white on this side. So it will generate the fall effect. And where the water is sitting exactly, it will be extremely white color because there we'll have the highest volume. And that's how the water is crushing down. And let's drop some more flowing river as water can't be stagnant. I'm just going up here so that mujhe rokega nahi. I'm just adding some more like random yahan pe falls. And then we are going to draw a river. Now, how to draw a river? Simple. Take some water, white. Don't wait for it to get settled. Just go for drawing random strokes. The density will be more at the starting point. It will decrease as you will come ahead. That's how you draw a nice, plain, simple flowing water. Let's add one more layer. These are just random horizontal strokes, giving some water effect. The background is entirely pitch brown. Some rush here, as there might be some stones underneath the bed. So a bit rushy here. And you can see we get a flowing waterfall. More randomize it for a moment. What we can do is I take some, now I'm left with here some white color. Instead of wasting it out, what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna grab some white. And here in the mountains, you can see sometimes the cloud surpasses the mountains also, as the mountains are quite high. So I'm just gonna drop some good white clouds here, give it more natural texture. These clouds are floating over this majestic mountains. The way it comes above Sahyadri, iske edges ko main merge kar dunga because I'm not having that much soft surface in the behind. Let have one cloud surpassing behind the mountain. So just took the cloud here. We just went like this random piece of furball, as you can see. But it's coming behind the mountain. One cloud is coming above the mountain, right here. And let's add some depth to the mountain. So like these are two layers. Let's make it different layer. Just gonna add some random clouds here, so that this element will come in. As I can see, the clouds are coming right from behind it. So it's the edge of a mountain. And you can see some random clouds coming right behind the edge, giving it this a clear visibility view. And some clouds we can show that it can't be some here. So now it's the entire monsoon scene. You can see clouds coming rushing from the thing. And you can see some random textures here. That's how you go and draw a landscape. And the final thing before I forget, how can a nature be without natural beings? So I just took a small brush and lightly in the atmosphere somewhere here, I drew a few spokes of birds. Like they are there, like at a very distant. And yes, you can see some spots in the ambience, and these birds are coming right straight away to you. And what we have left in the palette, I generally finished up with such a decorative material when I got some things left in my palette. As I got left with some more white, I'm gonna add a few more clouds here, a bit denser clouds, some more like flowing from this mountain, this mountain, In the monsoon, you will see a lot of such clouds. Wait, I'll show you original clouds also. I can see them through my window actually. So I'll show you even those clouds also. And I guess we are done. Anything else you want me to add in it, you can also suggest.
So can you give short brief? Because I have joined late.
Okay, so let's go for a short brief. We are first of all, are we missing some trees also? No, that is sufficient. Okay, but we don't have that much trees here. Okay, that is sufficient. We are also running late as it's 4 o'clock. As we have promised 1 hour, we are done with that 1 hour. Anyway, so the short summary is what we did. This is the painting. This is the final painting, can see here. Okay,
yes, I'll sir.
Drop it here. Okay, that's what the final artwork is. What we did, we started with acrylics on canvas. You know, acrylics are what we can say, opaque colors. So while using acrylics, we go from dark to light. I repeat, dark to light colors. That's why we draw the mountain first, then the waterfalls. First thing. Second, what we did, we draw the farthest thing first, then the closest thing. So we started with the sky with dark blue, light yellow, dark yellow. That's how we did the transition. The colors were wet, so we easily mixed them with the brush strokes, and we had a plain simple gradient from dark blue to dark yellow, as it was a morning sky kind of a thing. Then we drew some mountains here. We painted some mountains and we merged them in yellows. Why we did so? Because we wanted them to be far away. And these is yellow stuff here gave us the atmospheric effect, giving the clouds a distinct.
Which color?
Yes.
Mountain is giving by you. Which color, sir?
You can see here, this here, I'll use a brush. You can see here, this is a magenta. We use a purple kind of a color, but my color was wet while applying. So it got mixed with that yellow, and somewhere I can get a purple, somewhere I can get a brown shade. That's a play of color. Then why we use this yellow at the bottom? To give the atmospheric effect. That's why these mountains are looking far and these mountains are looking close. And what we did, with the brown, we covered all the thing in a brown color. We added some green patches on the top. As it's the Sahyadri's stone mountain, you can't have much green on the lower sides. These are rock cutting edges of Sahyadri mountains. So we added some few more little hilltops here at the bottom, and then we added waterfalls. Here we generated some water cloud, fog we called it as mountain water falls down, it raises into a water vapor at the base. And then with some random white lines here at the bottom, you can see we had some flowing water. And that's how we completed within 1 hour, a simple, beautiful landscape painting. Now, if you have want me to add something else to that, you can tell me. This was a basic, very basic. And the main thing is, there's no precision. I simply went on adding random strokes. I never planned my stroke too hard. I never painted them too carefully. I just enjoyed it. It was not a planned session.
In brown color, what you have mixed?
This one, na? I use brown color. If you don't have a darker shade of brown, you can add some blue or black to it to make it a chocolate brown.
Okay, sir. Blue and black with brown or brown. Red.
No, if you don't have a brown, if you have a lighter version of brown, mix some blue or black to that. And if you don't have brown at all, just mix black and red. You will get a nice chocolate brown.
Okay, sir. I have brown colors. Then next shade is green or yellow.
After adding brown, I took some yellow ochre and some green color, and then I just gave some random strokes on that. Now, if you all permit, I'll show you exactly how the atmosphere looks. Now, if you're here, I'm going to take you to the top of my house to show you exactly similar kind of ambience. So, with your permission, can I take you a floor up if you are done here?
Yes, sir. Please.
Okay. Yes, sir, please.
Okay, now just to have no interruption, I'll switch the video off for a minute until I go on the top and show you the real waterfalls here. So when you say what inspires us or what makes us happy, I'll show you. Okay, I'm at the top of my home. And as you can see,
beautiful.
There are some waterfalls also. I don't know, it can be zoomed or not. I'm trying to zoom in, but I'm not getting that thing.
I think we can see some waterfall.
Yeah, I can see a lot more with the naked eye. But you can see we have same random clouds here floating over the mountains. The mountains are actually stone mountains. But we are unable to see the stone color as it is ambience effect. It's going in a gray shade. And then all those gentle slopes, you can see some greens. But on the vertical wall, there is no grass because no soil can stay there. And if you can see somewhere here, you can see there are reverse waterfalls. Due to the pressure of the air, the waterfall is going up in the sky and not flowing down. That is one of the another beauty which we have here. In a straight line on the Anjaneri mountain, we see reverse waterfalls. The water goes straight up in the sky instead of flowing down.
Beautiful.
This is Anjaneri mountain in the outskirts of Trambakeshwar, Nasik city.
Very nice.
Beautiful.
I have another question.
Yes.
I live in Austria. So early in the mornings, the sky looks purplish. Okay. And in the evenings, it looks more pinkish. So how do you color this?
Okay. How do you color this? See, I will go downstairs. It's raining here. Just a minute. Otherwise, you won't be able to listen to me.
Thank you so much for showing all these things. You took me back a few years back.
You're most welcome for that. Just let
it's a beautiful
me
place.
So that we talk peacefully, because on the top it's heavily raining here. Okay, here I am back. So here we are with our painting. Okay, so your question was about the skies. So what happened in the morning when generally there is a sunrise? The sun, due to the sun, sometimes the sky gets orange, sometimes it gets yellow, sometimes it gets pink, depending on what season it is and what kind of clouds you have in your atmosphere. But in the morning, the sky is more lighter. If you are talking about orange, in the morning, your sky will be like light orange or yellowish shade. In the evening, it will be darker as sun is setting. That makes the differences.
I see it more purplish.
Yes.
In the morning hours.
So you will see lighter shades in the morning and darker shades in the evening. That's the difference.
Sir, now we did everything with you only. But after completing our painting, now we are observing that our hills, how you made that hills fall, it is not looking in our paint.
Okay. So how I made these hills fall? You can see I simply went for a straight line of water. And after that, what I did was I simply disfigured it randomly with brush strokes. All I kept in mind was the stroke should go vertical only. Now, for the very first time, it will be a bit challenging. I can agree. So
So after drawing it for let's two or three third time, second or third time, I guess it will be more clear what you want. The desired effect will be there.
Okay, sir. There's a question from Sumita. She asked how to clean the brushes after painting.
Okay. How to clean the brushes after painting. Now, depends on which colors you're using. For all water-based colors, like acrylics, posters, watercolors, simply first clean the brush with clean water. Generally, water in the vessel is usually dirty. So, first of all, take the brush, clean it in a under the tap or in a fresh water. Make sure entire moisture is wrapped from it. Take a dry cloth. Don't use rough cloth. Just keep the wrap the cloth around the brush bristles and gently squeeze it so it will absorb the moisture, and then keep the brush in such a position where its hairs or the bristles are not disturbed. I mean, they are like not tampered or not in a pressure. Keep them straight, generally upside down.
Thank you so much.
If you're using
thank oil, you sir, thank you so much.
Use turpentine, use some solvent. If you're using oil-based colors, you can use like solvents like kerosene or turpentine oil or linseed oil, something solvent which can clean the oil pigments from the brush.
Hi, sir, mera ek question tha ki acrylics ke liye aapne water use kiya hai. Normally, yeah, I'm in Muscat. Normally, यहाँ पे acrylics के लिए mediums भी मिलते हैं. क्या वो use किए जा सकते हैं blending के लिए?
Of course, आप medium को use कर सकते हो blending के लिए. Acrylics के साथ काम करने समय acrylics का very flexible color. उसका main क्या है? They are very flexible in application. So yes, you can use mediums also for acrylics. But water क्या होता है? It generally becomes very clean medium. So
okay.
आपको डर नहीं रहता तो सॉल्वेंट क्या होते केमिकल बेस्ड होते हैं यू सी
जी
रंग लगे हुए हैं
हां जी
ऑल ऑफ माय हैंड्स आर लाइक गेटिंग डर्टी
जी
निकलते नहीं है एंड अगर हम लेते हैं तो दे आर हार्मफुल फॉर हेल्थ सो आई यूज कर रहे हो सो वाटर से काफी अच्छे इफेक्ट्स आते हैं
ओके
सम इफेक्ट्स होल्ड ऑन
ओके
Now this is a work in progress. You can see
okay.
here.
Okay.
This is acrylics only.
हाँ जी.
And you can see the blending is quite good. You don't need
right
element for solvent for blending.
हाँ जी.
Not yet finished. Still you can see acrylics are giving good blend in water also.
हाँ जी. But sir, sometime patchy हो जाता है तो फिर उसको तो आप ठीक नहीं कर सकते क्योंकि वो acrylic है वो बहुत जल्दी dry हो जाएगा.
अरे वो patchy होता है. आप जब भी दो edges को merge करते हो, when you
merge
layers.
हाँ जी.
तो either merge them when they are wet. जैसे हमने एक layer दिया.
Right.
Color second layer दिया. उसकी edge को
wash कर दिया. Okay.
Second, if you are unable to merge two layers when they are take their intermediate color
okay
and then usko thoda dilute kar lijiye
haan ji
dilute karne ke baad uski mid layer pe aap usko wash kijiye
apne aap okay thank you so much
yes, I guess kuch aur sawal aaya tha maine miss kar diya text pe
There's another question. If a nearby object is to be added, like a tree, where should we add? Where it should be added?
If a nearby object is to be added,
आपके लिए क्या पड़ेगा?
Go for generally see, right? Don't go for the rules. Go for the view. What I mean to say is, human brain. आप जब भी पढ़ते हो, आप left to right और top to bottom पढ़ते हो. You have a habit of looking at things from top to bottom and left to right. अब यहाँ पे क्या होता है? Same goes for your canvas. अब जब भी canvas को observe करोगे, you will see it from left to right and top to bottom. That's the flow of your story. आज जो हमने painting बनाई, आपने देखा होगा हमारा mountain right half में था
and sky's left half में top पे थे. So I'll just simply switch on the camera. Sorry, switch camera. What? Okay. Yeah, you can see. जो हमारी painting है, इसको भी आप पढ़ते वक्त देखो. You can see हमने left में पहले sunrise दिखाया है. पहले क्या होता है sunrise. So what we did? First left to right, top to bottom. आप इसको देखोगे पहले हो रहा है sunrise. फिर mountains के ऊपर वो sunrise आ रही है. Then right side में आप देखो you see mountains. इसके ऊपर से waterfalls हो रहे हैं. And bottom right corner पे you see flowing water. So the story goes like morning sky, sun is rising, birds are flying. On a beautiful mountain you see falling water, waterfalls merging into a river and the river is flowing. So the way you write or read is the same way you paint. So ab aapka jo front object hai usko aapko kahan pe place karna hai aapki story ke hisab se. You want that object to be prominent, it should be first thing to be in your focus, to usko left top ki taraf se place karna shuru kijiye. It's not that much important, go for right side bottoms. Make a story of it.
There's another question, though I'm not clear what it says, but it says, can acrylic colors done on sheet?
By sheet, I guess she's trying to say paper.
Okay, she says, on which medium can acrylic colors be done? Okay. I guess it's the surface.
For sure, or panels. But when it comes to papers, any paper, what happens as compared to canvas, paper has high absorption capacity. So the moment you paint, it gets absorbed and you get lots of patchy strokes. You have to be really quick or you have to be really precise while working acrylics on paper. But on canvas, it takes time for them to dry or to settle. So you can go for, take some time and merge them. So on paper, you need to be more precise and more faster as compared to canvas if you're using acrylics.
The surface can be wall, can be wood, can be MDF, can be any surface, right? Even a metal.
Acrylic usually settles on any surface, usually. But depending on the surface to surface, after some time, it can worn out.
Do we have to actually varnish it?
Varnish is a question, interesting question in any scenario. Now, depends what feel you want from the painting. And second, where the painting is going to be placed. Now, in the ambience where you have challenging atmospheric conditions, like Trimbakeshwar, Nasik Spi, where you have heavy rains, chilled winters, and hot summers. So all the three ends are extreme. Here, how long can a piece of cloth sustain? So sometimes you might encounter with elements like dust, fungus, if the painting is not handled properly. Yes, how to hand store the painting? I'll tell that answer. So here, varnishing is good. It adds a protective layer over the colors. So you are not worried about fungus or dust or anything else. I generally recommend varnishing a painting unless and until you don't want that natural texture to miss out a little. But varnishing is good. You can varnish the painting. There are two types of varnish. One is a matte finish. Thank you, Adhika ma'am, for this beautiful comment. One is a glossy and another is a matte finish. When it comes to glossy varnish, your picture has a shiny finish. It reflects. The advantage is nobody can photocopy it because somewhere, somehow, they'll end up having some light reflections. But when it comes to matte finish, it doesn't give any reflection, but occasionally it reduces your contrast due to the matte finish. So you have to focus on the output, what kind of output you want, then decide whether that output is possible in varnish. If it's yes, then which one? Matte varnish or glossy varnish? How to store acrylic painting? Yes, that question I missed. How to store acrylic painting? Generally, acrylic paintings cannot be damaged naturally unless you poop them, tamper with them, it is being handled rough. If you have an acrylic painting hung up on your wall or placed on your table shelf, and occasionally, like once in a month, you're taking a dry cotton cloth and just dusting it out, not rubbing it, simply just take a cotton cloth and dust it out. So it will be safe. And if it's hung on a wall, in 6 months or 3 months, take it out, look for the back surface. You will find some spiders making some webs there, or in general, the cotton cloth.
Mask.
Get the insects settled for too long. That's the thing. Otherwise, acrylic paintings can't be damaged on their own. They are like decades long to have their life.
Thank you, sir. Thanks for nice painting. Thank you.
Did I miss any question? Let me just check the conversation box. Because occasionally what happens, sometimes I miss the questions. Okay, how to store acrylic paintings. Okay, if I haven't answered any of your question, I missed it out, please type it again so that I can answer it. I'm just in my chat box.
Zoom. I have a question. Yes. What I want to ask you is your experience with ArtMate, how is it like? I
personally think ArtMate is a very good brand, both in terms of the quality of their material as well as the service. The thing which you require in the field of art is precision and good quality products. Because when we charge our fee and make my paintings travel abroad. If you visit my profile, you can see paintings traveling from all the corners of country up to Europe and USA and international countries. So when painting goes there, and after some time, some damage happens or it gets worn or torn, then that's a bad impression. With ArtMate, I can guarantee you two things. One, the quality of material is excellent. So I have never received any complaint from any client that, so your colors are fading or your colors are changing, getting yellowish after a few years. No. And second, the quality of the service. I mean, you just name the thing and they'll make it available right at your doorstep, which is very important because as an artist, it happens like when I'm in a flow of painting for entirely a month, I don't step out from my home. But when something is missing, I simply call up ArtMate and they are like, okay, sir, it will be available to you within a matter of minutes or hours. And that's the best thing. I don't have to leave my flow and walk straight away down and search for the things in the market. Whatever I need, it's available with them. That's the best thing.
Thank you so much. There's another, not a question, but here we have someone asking, or rather many people have asked, that are we going to have more landscape workshops? Are you going to take few more?
Okay. Yes, we can do more. I mean, we can see. Today was our first workshop. So I stick to the time of 1 hour. Generally, paintings, we paint it for days or hours. So, and the more time we give, the more detailed it gets. The minute details. So if we are going to arrange more workshops, they are most welcome. Next time I'll suggest to have a session of more hours, or let's say we'll divide it instead of sitting for 10 hours a day or 5 hours a day. Let's say we say 2 hours per day for 3 days. So we get 6 hours, or 2 hours per day for 5 days. We get 10 hours. So we can explore much more minute details. When it comes to such detailed paintings, you can see my paintings in my profile or my Insta account. They are very minute details. I generally take a month or 2 months to finish one painting, but then we paint it in the similar detail. So if we are going to explore the depths, we will need to give time.
There are lovely comments thanking you, sir. And it was really a wonderful session. And anyone wants to say anything before we finish the session? I mean, there are lovely comments, but if anyone wants to say anything else.
Do you, are you planning classes here on this ArtMate?
That need to be discussed with the ArtMate team first.
Okay.
There are two scenarios here. First, I'll recommend if you're joining me for a journey of painting. Now, today, I did this particular painting just for you as a demonstration. Usually, we have more interesting subjects and more challenging subjects in our daily workflow. So if you guys are ready, what we can do is you join me for a journey of a painting. Let's say if next time I'm having a portrait painting order, something like this. What I'll do, I'll take you along with me in that journey. So you can see the details, how I'm painting with that, how I'm planning the picture all the way along till the entire painting is completed. So you can see a professional work happening in the most professional way.
Okay, on which platform are you going to do that?
Platform, I don't mind. It can be a Zoom also, it can be a Google Meet also. And if after this monsoon season, if time permits, and if the conditions in the market, like pandemic most of all, then someday we can have a physical workshop also, if everyone is ready. Face-to-face, live.
Okay. Thanks, dear, but I don't live in India. I can't have a face-to-face class with you.
So, the best thing will be, what we can do is, we have two options. I'll like to explore with the ArtMate team. As you won't be able to join me for 15, 20 days continuously, 3-4 hours a day, that will be too much challenging. What we can do is, we can have the making video. Generally, we record fragments of our paintings. You must have seen it in my promo video, how the entire journey is made. And now there are lots of tips and tricks, lots of secrets, which make that thing that much interesting. That effect is taken place. What we can do is, especially for ArtMate family, we can record the entire journey. That video might be 1 hour, two hour, or 10 hours long. Doesn't matter. And that video of the entire painting session can be provided to you. You can watch the entire video in the same detail in which the painting has been painted. You can learn the tips and tricks. And in this way, we can have this virtual sessions for a longer period of time, exploring much more depths of the painting.
Cool. Thanks a lot.
Yeah, so that way we can have, like, let's say I gave you a 4 hours video of a detailed painting. You have seen it as per your time, 1/2 hour today, 1 hour tomorrow, 2 hours later in some few more days. And then we'll decide a particular time, like today. We'll meet and you will ask me how that effect happened, if you missed out something. And we'll have a group chat, like we are having interaction right now. So how that part was executed. Even I can show you on a piece of canvas that particular effect, how it was done. So you can get to explore the complexity more. And yes, we can have a few more sessions of the basics. We can have it on 3 levels, basic, intermediate, and advanced. In the basic, we'll have sessions like today, where we'll go for simple subjects, exploring all the tips and tricks. In the intermediate session, we can have half live and half recorded. And in the advanced session, you can get a full advanced recording of an entire painting process with in-depth core elements, like from mixing the shades, to the selection of materials, to the portrayal of the subjects, anything. You contact ArtMate team for that. Let them explore the ways out.
Hello, my laptop's stuck.
Yes? You contact with the ArtMate team. Organizers, they will tell you more in that.
Ek minute,
you can take this thing ahead.
Main close karke laptop on karti hu, dekhti hu ekko.
If somebody is speaking to me, I can't hear you. The voice is too low. I heard some voice. It was too low for me to hear. Can you repeat if there is any question, or you can type it?
Actually, someone was saying I will close down my laptop and do it again because some kind of problem was there.
Okay. Thank you so much for clarifying it. Now, let me ask you one question. You can just simply raise your hands. How many of you are hobby artists and wants to explore the professional side of this field? Okay. I got one hand raised. Okay, two, three. Okay, everyone is almost.
Me too, sir. I will raise my hand.
Okay, everyone is almost raising their hands. Okay. So, very frankly, when it comes to professional thing, yes, you want to explore file, ma'am. Okay. So, very frankly, when it comes to your professional art field, you have to be connected, first thing, and you have to keep on exploring yourself. Easiest thing I'll recommend to start your art journey as a professional artist, start painting those subjects which are not available previously anywhere. Don't go for, like today we did something new, it was an imaginary thing. Same painting is not available to anybody else. So first, paint your favorite thing. Don't paint it from any reference. You can use reference to visualize your concept. Don't go for simply replicating it. Second, third thing, spread the word. Let everyone know your painting and you are willing to share your painting at a suitable, what we can say, exchange of currency, money, or any other facility. You're willing to trade, like everyone know. Because small paintings like for gifting or for these things, people generally tend to go for paintings. First, have a mini collection of yours.
Right. You're right, sir.
Start with a mini. Even at this date, I'm having a mini collection of mine. Anybody visiting my place should get to see 5-10 paintings. And then their ideas starts growing. And I'm sure ArtMate is a very great platform. Even I had a word with the team of ArtMate earlier. They are planning to organize lots of good events like online exhibitions, physical exhibitions. Exhibitions are good. Let people know you are there and what you are doing. So even we can go for online exhibitions, group exhibitions, physical group exhibitions like person to person if COVID our situation permits. And there you will find your buyers. And once you get into that stream, once you sell your one painting, I'm sure the same person is going to call you for a second one. He or she will buy it, not a question. Somebody from their friend circle, a friend, this thing work in this way. Trust and networking is the key.
Sorry, I had to take away my hand because I don't want to be a professional. I'm a hobby painter.
Yeah, even at this date, I can call myself a hobby painter. Professionally, I'm an engineer. I run an interior architecture design studio. So my main projects are like architect space design. I started painting as a hobby. I'm not a fine art graduate. I started painting as a hobby. I explored my hobby. Once or twice somebody asked me that they can buy my paintings or not. They liked it very much. So what they said, I like this painting. Can I have it from you? You name the price. I'll like to pay you for that, for your efforts, because you have used certain material. You had some expenses. This is where the journey started. Yeah, today also I'm painting paintings for myself and for people. So people like come to me, Siddharth, my birthday is there. My father's birthday is there. There's a marriage of my friend. Can you make me a portrait? I just moved to a new house. I want a beautiful landscape on my wall. I just started a new office and I have some of your artworks there. And I said, yes, why not? Let's settle down. Let's have a word and discuss it. So instead of me painting everything for myself, I'm spreading the happiness. Somebody comes to me and say, okay, can you paint something for me? I said, yes, why not? Few more people get to see that thing. So even as a hobby, you can perceive this.
So एक क्वेश्चन है. आपने कहा कि आप किसी के भी रेफरेंस को देख के पेंटिंग ना बनाए. बट इनिशियली मैं भी प्रैक्टिस करती हूँ, मैं ऑयल पेंटिंग में करती हूँ, मैंने अभी एक दो पेंटिंग्स बनाई हैं, बट वो रेफरेंस के साथ है क्योंकि वो एक कॉन्फिडेंस बिल्ड नहीं होता है कि आपको स्केच करना है. मेन बेस मेन मतलब बेसिक थिंग ही आपकी स्केच है. आप जब आपको कॉन्फिडेंस मींस वो नहीं आ पाता है मेरे अंदर कि मैं उसको स्केच करूं, दिमाग में बहुत सारी चीजें चलती है बट वो स्केच करने के टाइम पे वो हाथ ही नहीं आता कि कैसे करना चाहिए शुरुआत, तो फिर वही वापस दिमाग फिर वापस रेफरेंस पे चला जाता है. तो उसके लिए क्या चेंज करना चाहिए?
गुड क्वेश्चन. एंड नॉट जस्ट यू, मैं भी ये चीज को फेस करता हूँ. इफ यू हैव सीन, आई गेस माय शिवाजी महाराज कोरोनेशन पेंटिंग वाज प्रमोटेड फॉर दिस पर्टिकुलर थिंग, सो यू मस्ट हैव सीन इट.
जी.
सो इफ यू हैव सीन अर्लियर, आई स्केच्ड आउट द एंटायर पेंटिंग विद ब्रश ओनली.
जी.
इज background story. First of all, even this happens with us today. Now, I'm not saying don't see anything. That painting happened. I first studied the book of Shivaji Maharaj where the entire event description was given.
Okay.
Who were there, how they were sitting, how they were standing, how the coronation happened. Entire thing was there.
Okay.
I started with the background first. I took some image, some pictures of some forts from internet. I took pictures of the Shivaji Maharaj fort itself, but that is a good condition right now. So I took some more pictures from other forts, some other artist forts, anything. And I created concept. I first painted the background and then I went on painting the pictures. But what happened? The background get too big. The pictures like not everyone was getting accommodated there. So I took the entire canvas. I washed it out with the color. And then started with the Shivaji Maharaj first, the prime object. And I placed all the human figures first and then the background. So even it happens, we do a lot of R&D. It took me 4 days to sketch that painting alone. Four to five or five to six hours. So I have seen references. It's not like the basic thing is the design of the throne itself, the throne on which Shivaji Maharaj is sitting. It has two lions, it has an elephant. So these details. So I took a picture from the exact stone throne, which is there at Raigarh today. And then I sketched it out on a piece of paper for my reference. It's not like going completely without studying anything. What I mean to say is you take reference.
Right.
Reference and mold it in into a way instead of replicating the painting. What's you got?
Yes,
Shivaji Maharaj painting in the market. Why mine is special? Because in any of the painting, you can see Shivaji Maharaj either from the front view or from the side view. When that particular client approached me, the story is very interesting. I'll take just a minute here. The particular client first approached me 2 years before and said, I want to make a Shivaji Maharaj painting. I tell them the thing. They said it's too high from their budget. They went to the market. There are 5 to 6 homes in one single family of their uncles and aunties.
Okay.
Shivaji Maharaj painting in the living room. They went to the market. They found the same thing, the same picture copies of the painting. And the most irritating thing was either painting was from the side face entirely or from the front. You don't have in that thing. After 2 years and still having nothing in the living room, they came back to me and paint it the way you like, but make sure it should be superior than any of our family members. I mean, they have 6 paintings in their 6 to 7 houses. They want the best thing. And there I started the journey. For the first week, I studied the painting. I was there. They were in the front. Like, Anaji Panther, the characters. Was holding the umbrella, who was holding the Rajdand, anything was everything there in the detail, who was sitting, where they were sitting. Then I took a piece of paper, sketchbook, I sketched each single element, Shivaji Maharaj, his attire, his jewelry, then the throne, the Vara ambience, two-story. Women were not used to come straight in front of men. They used to be there in their balconies. That just the Rajmata Jizau and the queens were in the front on the respective thrones. We sketched out each single element on different piece of paper. We clubbed it together for a better view. Then we started the canvas itself. So there was lots of R&D. Even I sketched lots of references. I never replicated any other artist coronation painting.
Okay.
Special. That's what I want to say.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Hello, Siddharth. Priya here again.
Yes.
Good afternoon, all. I'm Priya from Artmate. And first, I would like to thank you, Siddharth, for this wonderful session. And I hope all the members has really enjoyed today's session, even though I also watched your complete session through our Facebook group. And I really liked it. The testimony I would like to share with the members, like the painting, Shivaji Maharaj painting, what the Siddharth was giving you the information. The link is given in the chat box. The video is there, YouTube video. You can just watch and you can see how amazing the Shivaji Maharaj painting he has made. And I will really recommend, and I'll speak definitely with Siddharth to have more sessions on our platform. And I again thank you all of you to join this session, and well, thank you Vandana for, you know, she's my right hand, and Siddharth, it was really nice session, and I'm going to personally try to make that landscape painting. I'm not an artist, I'm like beginner others. As a supplier, yes, I sell the products, but yes, by looking today's painting, I feel like I should try this. And thanks a lot again.
Thank you so much. Thank you everyone for your time, for your patience, and for joining me today's session. We'll be in touch. Whenever you feel you got all my details, you can be in touch with me. And I recommend you to be in touch with Artmate, honestly, because it's been years since I'm trusting their brand. And you go see my Instagram account, my YouTube channel, all my videos and paintings, all those fine details and the quality is being possible because of the good quality material. You can't go with a random car in a racetrack. If you want to go on a Formula One racetrack, you need the best quality car. So if you want to make a good painting, you need the best quality materials and tools. And with Artmate, honestly, it's been years and no complaints. Check out all the wonderful artworks, and you can see the result of their products.
Are the Artmate products available all over the world to buy?
Priyam, please answer this question.
Yes, ma'am. Actually, due to, you know, lockdown conditions, we are restricted within India only. But yes, very soon we will start exporting the material also.
There are other brands which are not available, for example, in Austria, but in UK. And I'm not willing to pay 4 times or 5 times of the price in Europe. I mean, it is also understandable. And naturally, I would prefer to buy something which is available in Europe, or rather in Austria, like, you know, exactly in Austria. I won't prefer to import it from UK, which where the products, Indian products, are very, very expensive. Few of them are about 5 to 6 times more expensive than in India. And then again, you know, paying the VATs is also the excess amount what we are paying them. So that's the reason why I was asking if you could export.
We will very soon. Yes. We can will definitely let all of us, you know, recover from this COVID situation, and we'll definitely.
Yes, of course. No problem.
Till then, I'd like to suggest you one thing. If you are able to visit your local art store for the moment, You can see there, you will find few of the brands which are available near you.
Hmm.
Try to take same colors of two or three different brands. Make same kind of a painting just for experiment. One subject, same colors, same shades, and two different brands. And then you can compare the difference yourself. Whichever suits you better, you can right now go ahead with that. Until I'm sure Artmate will come with their international facility, and then you will get the same thing which we all are using.
Okay, because the tubes what I'm using right now, acrylic tubes, the paint seems to be very thick, thicker than like what I see in Fevicryl or whatever brands you have in India. They seem to be more fluidish.
Hmm. Okay, now when it comes to thickness, we can dilute the acrylics with some solvent or water. That's a good thing. So if it is thick, then you can, it's good for you because then you can dilute it as per your convenience. But if you're not comfortable with that thing, I'd like you to go for some other brand. Try to explore the subject and then you can judge yourself better. Because I can't recommend like you go for this only or you go for that only.
Exactly.
Each one has our own comfort zones. And whichever is best for us, we have to choose that. So earlier step is experimentation. Unless and until you experiment, you won't find the best thing for you.
Another question about the oil paints. Which brand would you recommend? Because you've been using probably many brands. European brands, what would you recommend?
Honestly, I will never recommend any brand. There is a specific reason for this thing. No, I'm not saying the brands are not good. Of course, each one has their own unique quality and unique product. As I said earlier, the best thing is explore your nearby market. Let's say I'll show you one thing. Hold on. Okay, here I am. So I got, these are supplied by Artmate only. You can see by the packaging itself, these are good, same colors, right?
Oh, Liquitex.
One is of Camel, one is of Liquitex. Now, why I'm having multiple brands with me? Because each brand has its own, some plus points, some minus points. I mean, when you use colors, we come to know. Certain brands have certain good points, certain minus points. So for achieving the desired effect, which one is best suitable, we have to decide. So it's not like going for single brand always. Sometimes you need thick colors for giving that texture or giving that effect. Sometimes you need thin colors. So play with both. And then depending on what you want to achieve, decide which one you will prefer for using it.
But Siddharth, you can't keep on spending money on so many paints, right? So that's the reason why I asked you.
See, let me make it very much simple. You right now go to a nearby store, you will get two or three brands available, first of all. Just don't go for entire set. Take one color, one shade, and buy three tubes or three colors. Try each of them. You will come to know what effect they give. And honestly, instead of the tools are one part, but then your efforts, how much efforts you put in that artwork is the main thing. No matter how good the car is, unless and until you have the right driver, you can't win the race. So even if we give you good car, you have to be that right driver. And sometimes that right driver, even in the worst car, win the race. So trust yourself, whichever brand you are having in your hand, make sure you paint the best out of it, that nobody can challenge it.
So another thing about the brushes get spoiled very fast. Like the chisel is not so pointed anymore. See, after you use it for two or three times.
Yeah. First of all, I'll recommend you to use synthetic brushes if you're using for acrylics or oil based colors. And second thing, even if the brush gets worn out fast, first of all, we need both kind of brushes. For example, if I'm going to paint a tree, I'm not going to go for a smooth brush unless and until I need that fine stroke. Many a times I need rough brushes also. So I never throw out my brush. I still have brushes which I'm using since 10 years. So I have such brushes which I'm using from past 10 to 15 years. And I'm still using them, even if they are damaged. Because at some point, your clean brush, your new brush, can't have that natural texture which that rough brush or old brush can have. So it's not about how good the brushes are. It's about what you make them used to. So, and the best thing to make sure your brushes remain good for longer life is to clean them properly, because if the residue of the color or any pigment remains there and it dries out, then it spoils them. First thing. And second thing, while using brush, if you want to use on a rough thing, sometimes I need to drag them, sometimes I need to smudge them. So at these locations, I use rough old brushes to smudge, to drag, or some to handle rough textures. And for smooth lines, strokes, effects, I use the new brushes. So generally, I buy brush set once in a year. Yeah, that's my record. Once in a year, I buy new brush sets. And in 1 year, I paint approximately like 15-20 paintings of all sizes. I mean, big painting, small painting. Still, I get one brush set for 1 year, and that's cool. That much you can invest. I mean, it's just like a tires of your vehicle. It gets worn out with time. So once in a year, you need a brush, good repo. More than that, good, you're growing with that. But that much is required. You can't expect the brush to take you for years and years and years.
Sorry to interfere here. We will have to wrap the session now. But in case anyone does have a question, I have shared the link to Facebook. You can just comment there and we will try to answer all those questions.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you, Shilpiji. Thank you, everyone. And thank you so much, Siddharth. And thank you for answering so many questions. So we will come back to you in case there's any question. So you can reply back.
Bye-bye. Nice day.
Thank you so much. Can we wrap the session now?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you, Siddharth. Thank you, everyone. Thank you. Bye-bye. Take care and have a good weekend.
Thanks a lot.